Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.2 in the PERT CPM. So, in the earlier lecture, we discussed the construction of the PERT network and calculating the variance. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the PERT computations, various calculations of the PERT network and calculating or finding the critical path of the PERT network. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of the PERT network. First, the PERT computation. So, in the PERT computation, there are two types of computation. Forward pass computation and backward pass computation. In the forward pass computation, the initial event is assigned 0 time and the time of the succeeding events are calculated using the following formula. So, in the forward pass computation, we are going to calculate the earliest expected time of the jth event. So, the jth event, suppose in an activity, jth event is the end activity, end of a particular activity. So, the T stands for time, E stands for earliest expected and J stands for the event. So, it is maximum of all values of TEI plus small TEIJ. TEI is the earliest expected time of the initial event of the activity, that is ith activity. Then the TE, small TEIJ is the time taken for the activity IJ. So, we have to understand TEI is the earliest expected time of the ith event, small TEIJ is the expected time of the activity IJ and TEJ is the earliest expected time of the jth event. So, for any event, so there will be a circle representing the event, we have to divide the circle into 3 parts. So, this is the incoming activity, this is the outgoing activity. And we have to divide the circle into 2 of the top of the circle. We have to write the event number, normally 1, 2, 3 up to the end. So, we have to write the event number and the bottom portion we have to divide into 2. Left side is for TE value, the earliest expected time, and right side for TL value, latest allowable time. So, there are 2 time estimates. One is earliest expected time. In the forward pass computation, we calculate the earliest expected time. In the another method, another backward pass computation, we calculate the TL value. So, both value we have to write here. And backward pass computation, calculation starts from the last event in the network. So, in the forward pass computation, we start from the beginning, initial event. And in the backward pass computation, we have to start from the last event. To start the calculation, the time of occurrence of the last event is fixed. Suppose it is given in the problem, we have to take that value. If it is not given, it is taken to be equal to the earliest expected time of the event. So, if the value is the latest completion time of the project is given, then we have to fix that is the TL value. If it is not given, we have to take TE equal to TL. So, here the latest allowable occurrence time of the ith event is calculated. The latest allowable occurrence time of the ith event, TLI equal to minimum of all TLJ minus TEIJ. So, TLI is the latest allowable occurrence time of the ith event, TLJ is the latest allowable occurrence time of the jth event and TEIJ is the expected time of the activity IJ. So, these 2 calculations we have to calculate, then we have to calculate the slack and the critical path. The slack is defined as the difference between the latest allowable occurrence time and the earliest expected time of the event. So, for any event, Sj equal to Tlj minus Tej for any event. The slack indicates the time by which the event can be delayed. If the slack equal to 5, that means we can delay the activity by 5 days. If the slack equal to 0, then you have to be very careful. You cannot delay the event. So, we have to conduct the event or complete the event in the stipulated time. The event with a 0 slack is called as critical event. So, the critical event you have to determine. So, slack is the parameter, so which will allow us to execute the project at our convenience. But when the slack equal to 0, that is the critical event, we have to be very careful. An activity is known as critical activity when the head event and the tail event has this 0 slack. So the event, critical event, for an activity, if the head event and the tail event both are critical, then the activity is very critical. So critical activity, that we have to very careful, and we have to conduct the activity as per the schedule, and we should not delay further. If you delay the critical activity, the entire project will be getting delayed, and we have to carefully conduct the activity, and we have to pump all the resources required for that particular critical activity. So how to calculate the critical, what is the condition? TEJ minus TEI equal to TLJ minus TLI equal to TEIJ. So TEIJ is the expected time of the activity. The formation of forming an unbroken chain of critical activity from the start event to the end event is called as critical path. So the forming. So we have identified the critical event, critical activity, and the forming and unbroken chain of activities from initial to the final, it is called as critical path. So forward pass computation, we are going to calculate the earliest expected time. Backward pass computation, we are going to calculate the latest allowable occurrence time. Then we have to find the slack of the event. If it is 0 slack for the event, then it is critical event. If the activity has got the head event, tail event, slack equal to 0, then it is critical activity. Then we have unbroken chain of critical activity from the beginning to the end, that is called as critical path. Now we take one example to calculate the critical path. So example number 4, task A, B, C up to H and I, it constitute a project. The notation X less than Y means the task X must be finished before Y can begin with its notation. That means A is less than D, A is less than E, B is less than F, D is less than F, C is less than G, C is less than H, F is less than I, and G is less than C. A is less than D, that means activity D can start only after completion of A. E is less than A, that means activity E can start only after the completion of A. So like that, we have the precedence relationship. Draw the graph to represent the sequence of tasks and find the minimum time of completion of the project work. When the time is given in days of completion of each task is given in the table below. For task and time in delay, time in days, A 8 days, B 10 days, C 8 days, D 10 days, E 16 days, F 17 days, G 18 days, H 14 days, and I 9 days. So first we take the draw the network diagram, network of the project work. So we have repeated the precedence relationship, A less than D, A less than E. So this is the activity A, first activity, they start independently. So the B is also starting independently, C is also starting independently, and the ABC activities, they are independent, and the activity D, it is completed after A. So this is the first precedence relationship, D is after completion of A, and the E is after completion of A. So E is after completion of A, and the F is after completion of B. So F is after completion of B, F is after completion of D. So F starts from after completion of B and D. So B and D, it is finishing here, then the F starts. Then G after completion of C. So G is starting after completion of C. Then H after starting completion of C. So H is starting after completion of C. And then I starts after completion of F and G. So this is I, F and G. And then we have the final event. So this is the final event and the starting event. There is no connection between these two, and we connect the two events by means of dummy activity. So dummy activity, they consume 0 man hour and 0 resources. They are not consuming any resources. It does not take any time for completion of that particular activity. Now we have to number all the events. So first we take the first event as 1. So you delete all the activity emerging from the first activity. Now this becomes the second, and this is not the third, because this is becomes third because there is no incoming arrow. So here we have one incoming arrow. So next we drop the activity D and E. Now this becomes the initial event. So this is 4, and this becomes 5. So this becomes 5, 6 and 7, and finally this becomes 8. So these are all the 8 event. So the 8 event, all the activities A, B, C, D up to I, the time is given 8 days, 10 days, 8 days, 16 days, 17 days, 18 days, 9 days, and dummy activity they consume only 0 days. So these, the values are written here. Now we have to calculate the expected time using the forward pass computation. We have to calculate the earliest expected time. So for the first event TE1, we have to fix TE1 as 0. Then TE2, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE2 equal to TE1 plus TE12. So the expected time of the first event plus time of that particular activity. So 0 plus 8 equal to 8. So here we have to write 8. TE3, so this is TE3. So TE1 plus TE13, so that is 0 plus this 8. So this is the 8. So 8 is the time taken, earliest time taken for the third activity. Then for 4, there are two incoming arrow. So this is one, B is the incoming arrow, D is the incoming arrow. Now we have to calculate maximum of, so the earliest expected time of the fourth event is maximum of the two time. There are two root, so we can calculate TE2 plus TE24. So 2, so 8 plus 10 equal to 18. Another one is TE1 plus TE14. So TE1 plus TE14 equal to 0 plus 10 equal to 10. Maximum of these two values is 18. So we have to, in the forward pass computation, we have to take the maximum of these two values, which is 18. So 18 is the expected time of the fourth event. Now for the fifth event, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE5 equal to TE2 plus TE25. Which is 8 plus 16, 24. And the TE6, again we have only one incoming arrow. So TE6 equal to TE3 plus TE36 equal to 8 plus 14 equal to 22. Then TE7. So for TE7, there are two incoming arrow. So F and G. So for TE7, TE4. So TE4 plus the time. TE4 plus TE47, 18 plus 17 equal to 35. Or TE3 plus TE37, 8 plus 18 equal to 26. So maximum of these two value is 35. So 35 is the time for expected time for the active event 7. And TE8, maximum of 3. There are 3 incoming arrows. So TE5 plus TE58, 24 plus 0 equal to 24. TE7 plus TE78, 35 plus 9 equal to 44. And TE6 plus TE68, 22 plus 0 equal to 22. So 24 plus 0, 35 plus 9, 44, 22 plus 0, 22. The maximum value is 44. So this is the 44. So the construction of the network, numbering the event and calculating the completion time. So the 44 days are required for completion of the project work. So the answer to the problem, the minimum time required to complete the project is 44 days. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information on the PET and CPM. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another video lecture in the PET and CPM to calculate the critical path of the network. Until then, bye.